Now, if you don't have the interest or the money to buy a TIG welder, to upgrade to having a TIG welder, have multiple machines, probably the most simple way that you can get going with welding aluminum is you can use your MIG welder. With the MIG welder, you do need to convert to a spool gun. So this is an aluminum welding spool gun. So the reason that you need a spool gun, it actually has the spool up in here, as it would suggest by the name. The reason you need this is because the aluminum wire is much softer than the steel wire. So if you put the aluminum wire in the machine and it has to travel all the way through your torch lead, you would basically have the wire bunching up within it because it's just too soft of a wire. So with the spool gun, you have your wire right here, and it only has to travel a short, straight distance to come out of the gun, and you're welding. So this method of welding aluminum is probably as compared to TIG, it's a little more messy. It creates sparks and spatter like a MIG welder does. But if you tune the welder up and there's a couple key things you can do, it can help you make some pretty good aluminum welds. And as with anything, if you practice, you can get pretty good with it. So to convert this over, at least on the MIG 175, like we have here, it's really simple. You would pull your torch lead out, and you unscrew your plug here, your trigger switch. You pull that out, put the spool gun in, tighten this down, and then inside the machine, there is a little switch. You switch it over to spool gun. And that'll allow you to weld with the spool gun instead of with normal steel welding with the torch. So that'll let you activate it in here. So with welding aluminum, a big thing that we see, at least with the spool gun, that people kind of forget, is with MIG welding with steel, you can get away with welding something that's kind of dirty, may not be clean the best. I know I've done it, and other people do it all the time, and something might be a little rusty, or there might be a little bit of primer left over. You can kind of get away with burning it off, and it works okay. With aluminum, to get the best foot forward, you really need to clean the part as good as you possibly can. Take the extra time to really clean the part down, especially with MIG welding versus TIG welding, because you have a little less control over what the arc's doing to get any type of extra cleaning advantage. You don't have that with a MIG welder, so you need to clean it really well. So what I've done, what I've done is I've taken this little angle grinder here, 36 grit, and I've sanded this part that we're going to weld here, this little weld joint. And I've sanded just the areas that we're going to actually be welding on the inside there. So one thing you want to do before we actually weld it, you want to at least hit it with a wire brush, a stainless wire brush, to clean off the area you're welding. Might clean any minor contaminants off of the piece. It could have got on it from it sitting, so we're going to do that real quick. All right. So if you want to take it a step further, you can use the low VOC pre-painting prep or 100% acetone or a mild cleaner similar to that. Is it completely acceptable to use in this case? But to save the time of letting that flash off, we're just going to get going here, let you guys see. It's going to be difficult for you to see the actual welding process because we're kind of blocked here. But you should be able to see and hear the sound of what it's like when it's welding. And then we'll flip it around and let you guys see exactly what it looks like. Now, one thing you may or may not notice, is that you need to move really quick when you're welding with a spool gun on aluminum with a MIG welder. There's no stopping. As soon as you start melting, you got to start moving really quick because it wants to heat up and burn through, no matter what your settings are. So to be in that optimum heat setting and wire speed, you need to really move quickly. You got to really identify that puddle immediately and start pushing it along. So with the settings, they're kind of, if you're used to what you see on a when you're welding steel, MIG welding steel, it's kind of a lot different. You might see here we got the wire speed pretty much maxed out, and we got the machine turned up about halfway, I'd say. It's like E and a half is the setting there. And I got the wire speed maxed out. That's because we need to get as much wire as we can down into the piece to melt, to create that arc and melt the two pieces together. So I'm going to start this up here. We're going to lay a weld down, and then I'll flip it over and let you guys check it out. And we're gonna start moving here. So you could probably see I was moving really quick there. I wasn't sitting in one spot at all. With this, one thing I did forget to mention, you do need to have 100% argon. So when you're welding aluminum with the spool gun, you need to switch it over to 100% argon. You cannot use your mix bottle, your CO2 argon mix bottle. Cannot use that. You need to use 100% argon. So if you have the MIG welder and the spool gun, I would at least keep a small bottle on hand. If you're doing a little bit of aluminum welding, keep that on hand so you can switch the bottle out. Only takes a few seconds. So here you can see, before I've wiped anything down, what it looks like. You can see some, there's the black soot around the outside edge there. That's just the dirt and contaminants that are popping off. It's kind of not nearly as clean of a weld as you would see with TIG welding. So with this, we should see on the back side, you can see it was starting to, this is pretty warm here. We were dancing around burning through there. You can see some little spots where I was starting to get all the way through. So that's what you're fighting that whole time. The other big problem is aluminum is a heat sink. So as you're welding about halfway through, the piece is going to start heating up. And with a MIG welder, there's no way to vary the heat. So you need to move faster. So as you start welding, you actually need to move quicker as you get more to the end, because the piece is heating up. You're at a greater risk of burning through the piece. So you really gotta keep an eye on the penetration that's happening with your weld so that you don't burn through. It's really important on MIG welding. So I'll hit this with the wire brush here. I'll show you what it looks like after you're done. All right, so there's a little view of our the aluminum piece we just ran. So you can get a similar effect as welding steel with aluminum. It takes a bit of practice. I'll admit I'm a little out of practice because I can TIG weld, so I don't pick up the spool gun as often as I should, but it's still really great to use. The spaces, the times that I'd use a MIG spool gun over a TIG welder, you can get into tight spaces that you may not be able to get into with a TIG welder. If you're welding something that's, you just can't get clean enough, a TIG welder, you'll probably fight it and won't be able to really get a weld. With this, you can at least get away with something that's a little dirtier. You can still at least get a weld. It may not be as pretty as you'd like, but you can still lay a weld down in somewhere that a TIG may not be able to at all. So it does have its advantages, and also, you know, obviously the advantage is that you don't have to buy a different machine. You can just have your spool gun on hand, and you can use your MIG welder. So that's the basics of what it looks like, what it sounds like to weld aluminum with a MIG welder versus a TIG welder. I hope you guys learned something. If you have any questions or have any ideas for future tech videos, be sure to leave a comment on the video here, or drop us a line through email. Make sure you follow us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and subscribe to our YouTube channel here to get any updates on any future videos. We do it all. Thanks for watching. We'll check you next time.